are teens in our generation so violent?
I think that teenage violence is just a result of, I think, bad society. I think, you know, with kids that have no direction and the kids that have no kind of guidance, they tend to want to do things on their own. It's like being in the jungle, you know. If everyone's hungry and it's like a plate of food to eat, everyone's going to be rushing for that thing. So I think that people just need to understand that kids just need guidance, you know. They need to know the right way to live.
My opinion on that? Wow, I think it's really getting worse and worse, and I think it's horrible. You know, honesty, and I think it's over stupidness as well. Like, absolute rubbish. And if people realise the value of life, what it was doing to people, what it's doing to their families, and like what God and Jah would actually want, it just doesn't make sense, in my opinion.
It upsets me. I'd say it's something that's unnecessary and really doesn't need to happen. I mean, young people, when you think about it, they're the future at the end of the day. And the minority that engage in teenage violence, they're leading to a negative view of the whole group. I mean, because of the minority and the actions of a few, it leads to the whole group being demonized. And I don't think that's right, because they're jeopardizing the opportunities of the mass of youngsters. And I think teenagers are a group that really need to be encouraged and need as many opportunities as they can, because they're the future at the end of the day.
I think it's unnecessary and stupid, and it's a waste of your life, to be honest. And offer status and postcode wars, it makes no sense. Like, you have to think bigger. Simple.
Well, teenage violence, I think, I don't know, I think it's just very hype and something we really don't need. But, you know, there's like loads of reasons why kids can be on the streets for boredom, or so, like, so many different reasons. Like, for me, like, let's say like 1 or 2 years ago, like, I almost got robbed like 3 times. Like, around Leytonstone, all these areas, it's like, I don't know, like, I don't know, you can say, oh, Peckham, Brixton are the rough areas, but it's everywhere, like, everywhere's got the bad places, but I don't know, like, it's just real hype for me, so.
Well, I think it's just getting ridiculous nowadays, and that, like, it just happens too much. Like, it feels like the children are just bored and have nothing to do, so that's why people go out of their way to just make trouble and violence and cause trouble with other people. Yeah,
I don't think people's gonna listen to me or something, to us, because like it's happened everywhere. It's not just in UK, because like we both for France, this is the same thing. So it's, I don't know what can we do.
Well, I don't agree with teenage violence, because I've got a younger sister, and obviously this area, a lot of things have happened, but it's all because of the postcode wars and all that. I don't really agree with that.
People are too angry nowadays. Wow. We need to chill out. I think it's like teenagers, testosterone and stuff. I think it's too much anger.
It's not okay. It's not good. And it's not just about teen violence. We need to get the parents around the table as well.
My opinion about teenage violence is, I believe it stems from the kind of role models. People like me should be empowering to the children and into the young teenagers. I believe they need more role models on the street. And I believe I'm an empowering force. I believe I could change the lives of youngsters. But I believe youngsters need to rewire their thinking and reprogram and not listen to the media. And they should listen to people like us, which are big sisters, big brothers out there. I'm just coming back from the National Achievers Award, the National Achievers Congress with Sir Richard Branson, Sir Alan Sugar, and Tony Robbins. And I believe I'm very empowered. And I believe if youngsters should come to events like this, their lives will never be the same. If they can give you the tools for success, but you need to take action. And the only way you can take action is consistent actions over a consistent period of time. Knowledge is not power, activity is power.
So why do you think they're committing crimes in the first place?
People need to know themselves and they need to love themselves. Real talk, because it's like, I think when they see other people, they don't realise that in a way they're looking into themselves, you know what I'm saying? Everyone's like equal, we're all human beings all together, you know what I'm saying? And when people don't realise that, when they don't look into another person and see that, then they don't, I don't know, I don't, like, they don't feel like, they won't realise the effect that what they're doing has on the other person in other ways, and their families and so on and so forth.
I think most people aren't going to agree with me in this, but I think it's down to boredom. I think that if you commit a crime, you're not really doing it because you don't think about everything when you commit the crime. You know, you think about the good things, you don't realise the bad things. If you commit a crime for the first time and you go to prison, you don't know what prison's going to be like. So you commit the crime because you see the benefits of it, and you need to realize that, you know, kids commit crimes because there's just nothing else to do. You know, they need things to do. We need fun. You know, we need a way out of society's problems.
Because of the post-code wars. Yeah, obviously how you bring up your kids definitely is a big role on how they, it reflects on how they act, yeah.
I mean, people can blame the government a lot, you know, with like, well, there's not enough things to do, or, you know, that could be like the typical thing, or parents, you know, the dad's not around because there's always the single mums and all that stuff. So, I don't know, like, you know, sometimes they just don't have people to look up to and go, okay, I want to be like that. So they look for places to go, to look for this stuff, and then they look at the wrong place and they think, okay, I'm fitting in right now, so this is what I'm going to start doing. And then it's just like, keeps on stacking up.
What's your opinion?
I think my opinion is that most boys don't have their dads in their lives, and I feel like mothers, as I said, they can't raise a man. No, it's hard to raise a boy as it is. So I think that men need to step up with their sons, you know, guide them and train them. Maybe that will help.
You know, I think there's a number of reasons. I think there's a sense of wanting to prove themselves. I think they want to prove that there's something. You know, they see these guys, the thing is, there's the gangs, they see them as kind of someone to look up to. I don't know, there's many reasons, so I don't know what to pinpoint it to, but I think one thing is that they feel as though they have to prove themselves. I mean, a lot of them are from underprivileged backgrounds, and they think that the only way they can make something of themselves is to join a gang, and being a part of a gang usually includes maybe validating yourself with an act of violence to show that you're not scared or shook, or that you're bigger and badder than this other gang or someone in this postcode. And so, yeah, I think it's just about, and also that they think a sense of community, they want to belong somewhere, they want to fit in, and they want to be respected, and they feel as though being part of a gang is somewhere where they can gain this respect and be respected. So I think that's the real reasons, the heart of the issues.
I don't think they can imagine themselves in an environment outside their own hood or outside their own community. So that's why they act like this is the only thing that they have. But there's a lot of other things, you know, you can travel the world. It doesn't stop there. So.
Economics, money, aspirations, monkeys see what monkey do.
Brother and sister, together we'll make it through. Oh, yeah. Someday a spirit will take you and guide you there. I know you've been hurting, but I've been waiting to be there for you. And I'll be there just helping you out whenever I can.
This one's for all the ones sharing love. It's appreciated. Life's crazy, man. Hey, listen to the lyrics. Look.
Stay with me. Don't fall asleep too soon. The age of your way for a moment.
They can wait for a moment.
Stay with me. Don't fall asleep too soon.
I won't.
The age of your way for a moment.
Listen to the words. Look, don't cry for me when I'm gone. No point in wasting tears. Our time will come one day, and I'm just confronting my fears. Though it's not really a fear, it's more like a destiny. Sometimes I sit and wonder, is this life really for me? Cause I've seen, heard, felt, and done. I hope you're proud of where I've come. You see me grow and help me through, and there is no repaying you. I'm here and I feel like I'm delaying you, betraying you. And when I'm gone, I hope that someone's saving you.
Stay with me.
I'm gonna stay, listen. I'm gonna try not to. Can wait, man. I swear.
Stay with me. Don't fall asleep too soon. The age of
I wanna see your face every time I come home. Cause I can't leave you like this in this cold world alone. But in this life we're living, who knows when I'll be gone. I don't wanna leave you with what is held in for long. To the world, there's too much to prove. But sometimes I wonder what I really have to lose. And then I really see, it's not all about me. I wanna shield you from this harsh, mad reality. It's real, look.
Less risky sometimes, but really you gotta take chances. It's crazy, look. Listen to the words. To the world. Life's a game and you need to play it correct. Do the right moves and don't get caught up in loads of mess. Be calm, don't be stressed. Be sure to pass your test. Stand your ground and don't let others put you to the test. Life's a game and you need to play it correct. Do the right moves and don't get caught up in loads of mess. Be calm, don't be stressed. Be sure to pass your test. Stand your ground and don't let others put you to the test.